We got to talk about this crazy Benzinga article that came out. I almost didn't believe it was real. Let's check it out. Look at this. This Tesla analyst must be on a hallucinogenic drug, says value investor in response to Morgan Stanley's value proposition. Hold up. Just imagine this for 1 second. Imagine that you have a job as an analyst, not even you. Take it out of your shoes, right? Imagine it's your aunt, your uncle, your mom, your dad, and they're working at the bank and they're working at Morgan Stanley. And they say, you know what? We think Tesla is going to go up to this price. And a mainstream media news article says that you must be smoking whatever. Now, family, that's absolutely nuts. Before we get into the rest of this, this episode is brought to you by our good friends at Tendies. I want you to be informational. I don't want you to be emotional. Let's take a look at Tendies. We can see that they are betting literally $10 million. Look at this. $10 million against Microsoft just for one option play. $14 million. And then Meta, they're betting $2 million and then $5 million. Family, we can see that the institutions who have billions of dollars to play with and gamble away, family, they are betting heavily against these stocks for January 2023. Now, be informational. Don't be emotional. You got to be able to see this stuff. And they generally charge, not Tendies, but other platforms that give the same kind of information. They generally charge like $30, if not even $400 a month, so that you could just have access to the information that the big dogs have so we could see what they do and not necessarily what they say. And when you look at Meta, it's down 10%. So when they're betting against these companies like that, they're making a lot of money, if not double their money on that. But let's get back to that article, family. Check this out. Benzinga, they said that this analyst, who we're just going to call Jonas for now, said that it's going to $330 a share. And they said that on Wednesday morning, family. So this just recently happened. So now, again, they're saying that in order to think something like that, you got to be smoking something, family, that hopefully they're not selling in the pharmacies. But you never know nowadays. It's 2022. So let's check this out. Let's see why they're saying that. Benzinga is thinking that Tesla is going to 150. Now, does that mean that you should buy, hold, or sell Tesla? No, I'm here to give you the facts so you could be the judge. And happy Thanksgiving, by the way, family. I'm thankful for you. But let's keep it going. Tesla, they said it's approaching their 150 bear case and it's driven by price cuts in China, decelerating demand for EVs, and just the current market in general. So now, what's going on here? Understand, the Fed, what they're doing is they're trying to make money and actually succeeding. They're making money more expensive to borrow. When you try to finance a car, right, it's going to be higher to pay because the interest rates on that is going to be higher. If you get a mortgage, it's going to be higher. You can see your gas prices are going up. People's rents are going up. People have less money to buy things that could be considered a luxury. For example, a Tesla. If you need a car, you might not need a Tesla. You might go and get a Toyota. You might go get a Nissan. I don't know what it is in your area. But understand, when people buy luxury items, sometimes these prices come down for the average everyday consumer. Or actually, not prices. Sometimes the amount that luxury items are purchased by average everyday people, it's reduced because they don't have the money anymore. Everything is just more expensive. They don't got money to go get Tesla. So then these things happen. But what does it do for people like me? Oh, yeah, when I see a price I like, I strike. So then I let it come on down, and then I just DCA, I average in. But let's keep it going. They're saying that they see it going to 150. Do I personally see it going to 150? Honestly, it could go lower, especially if we enter into a hard recession. We've already been in a recession, but whether they tell you we're not in a recession or not, family, we've been in a recession. Let's just keep it real. Let's keep it raw. You've seen the stock market been coming down. The economy has been gradually getting worse, but inflation is at a 40-year high. Stop letting these people lie to you, family. We've been in a recession, but let's keep it going. They said this, why Tesla stock is having its worst year yet. So understand me, Tesla stock is not having its worst year yet, in my opinion. There's been years where they thought the company was going to go out of business. I guess you could argue that they're having the worst year ever, but understand this, the company is still profitable. What it means with this is, oh, if the stock is coming down, but the company is doing well, then that means that you can find value there and actually load up. Now, I'm not telling you to load up, but just understand this is what I'm doing. And I know that, hey, post-recession, once this is all done and Tesla is back on the uptrend, I just been buying it and I'm going to be all good. So now, China, they're saying the lockdowns is potential, more lockdowns coming for China. And they've recently been on more lockdowns for the pandemic. But they're also saying Elon's takeover of Twitter is actually impacting the stock. And I know you can't see this well. Let me try to move this up just a little bit so you can see it a little bit better. But they're saying Elon buying Twitter is taking his focus off of his other companies like SpaceX, like Tesla, for example. And they're saying that the company is suffering from that. So now let's take a look at this. They're also saying that the automaker is poised to have, again, the worst year in history due to those factors. So let's keep it going. We got to talk about value. When you look at a stock, if you've been watching me for a long time, you know where we're going with this. That PE ratio. It's not the end all be all, but it's a good, just quick test, like a standard test that you can see and say, okay, what's the standard? The Fortune 500 companies, aka the SPY. Now, the PE ratio is 19, which means if you give them $19, they're going to give you back a dollar. Think of it simple like that. So that's the standard. Give them 19, you get back a dollar. Tesla's PE ratio, even after it fell down a lot this year, let's take a look at that. It's 52. You got to give them a whole $52 for them to give you a dollar. So now that we're not in a bull market anymore, we have to look more at these fundamentals. What is the price of the stock versus what they earn? And that gives you the PE ratio. So now you got to get them 52 for them to give you a dollar. So family, the value, it could still come down closer to that 50, but I'll show you exactly where the floor should be if it continues to come down on a bear market. So now let's check this out. We got Tesla is up 8% today almost, and we'll talk about why. However, on the week it's almost flat at 48%, and on the year family is down 48%. So now let's see this, and let me go back real quick. So I might have said on the week is down 48%. No, on the week is down 0.48%. let's be clear, let's keep it real, let's keep it raw. And then on the year is down 48%. But check this out, this is what got it running up. Tesla's full self-driving beta is now available for all people in North America. So that's huge for the company because they've been talking about robo-taxis for years. And this gets us one step closer to that, which will be another income stream for Tesla potentially. Now let's get into the details. They're saying this. They're saying that it's available and it used to be limited to people who only had high like driving ratings. So what we're gonna see though, let's keep it real. Let's just be honest. Now that you're seeing more self-driving with more people who have the full self-driving service, you're gonna get more accidents. But what happens is when you really look at the data, these self-driving cars, they're actually better drivers than the average everyday person, right? Now, the reason that you're gonna see more accidents is because way more people are going to have it. So let's say the average everyday person, I'm gonna throw a number out here, right? Just so you get an idea. Let's say that they crash, one crash is like 1 in 1,000. For the self-driving car, it could very well be 1 in 100,000 or 1 in 1,000,000. But when a computer is driving and if somebody gets hit, it's front page news, family. So they'll have you think it's worse than it actually was, but it's actually statistically, it could be lower. So now let's keep going. Let's get to the facts. Now, here goes some price targets. Now, they thought that whoever that was from Morgan Stanley was smoking whatever. Look at this. They said that Tesla, this is an analyst, right? They said that they see it going to 760. Family, the highest target is 760. Right now, we're at about Tesla. I just said it. We're at 180, right? They're saying it's going to 760. They're saying on the median, the average analyst is saying it's going to 310. And then on the low, they're saying it's going to 85. But again, you always got haters on Tesla. So let's check this out. Let's look at what the big dogs are doing as of last quarter. On attendees, you can see what they're doing basically today and what they're doing yesterday. But on the institutional ownership, family, I'm looking at it right now. Out of the 10 top owners, Vanguard, BlackRock, all of these kind of institutional owners, Baillie Gifford, only two of them was actually selling shares last quarter. Everybody else loaded up. Vanguard picked up 7.9 million. Family, analysts are telling you, you must be smoking drugs if you want to pick up Tesla. That's crazy, right? But what are they doing? The people who actually own these big companies, most of them, 8 out of 10 of them are buying. 80% of them are actually loading the boat. So let's keep it going. And when you look at who owns Tesla, 44% is owned by institutions. And again, last quarter, they picked up 88 million shares versus the 63 million sold, aka way more buying than selling from the institutions, family. So again, remember what they do, not what they say. So I was telling you, we have a floor somewhere around 130, let's call it 129.35, just about right there. This is the October 30 lows that we got to keep our eye on, because on a technical standpoint, this is where a lot of volume is, but it's a lot of buying volume, which shot it up last time, the last time, you know, when we were really locked down in the pandemic. So now, this doesn't mean that it won't hit 150 like Benzinga is saying, but it could. If it goes under that 150, it's likely to come to that 129 as well. So I'd be willing to pick it up there as well. But remember, this is the stock market. There's no guarantees in most things, especially when they're heavily manipulated. I don't think Tesla is as manipulated as something like, let's call it AMC, for example, but you know how the big dogs roll. So we know, and always be in understanding of this, that even though we might say this could be a floor, things can fall under the floor. You got to ask yourself, are you an investor in Tesla or a trader? So then you know, how are you playing it? When you trade, you want to get in, get up, and get out. When you invest, you play a seed and you want to let that seed grow. And that's how I'm playing Tesla. So now, again, they're saying that people thinking Tesla is going to go up like that must be on drugs. Personally, I think it's going up long term. I think in this bear market environment that we're in, a lot of people are going to say whatever they want just to try to push their narrative. And to be honest with you, family, there are a lot of people who are investing in Tesla and institutions who are investing in Tesla that are playing options. Like I was just showing you on Tendies with Microsoft and Meta and all these other things. There are people playing millions of dollars worth of Tesla. And what are they doing with that? They give you a price target like 760, but they don't really think it's going to go up there. They're just doing that so that you think it's going to 760. So then when it goes up to 200, boom, they can let it go and they can make all of the money. This is why we got to make sure that we know what they're doing versus what they're saying. The Tendies link is pinned to the top comment. I see you in the next one. But if you can't handle the heat of these hot stocks, then stay out of the kitchen. You know what? Have a good Thanksgiving. I love y'all. I see you in the next one. Take care.